We're going to get to our destination safe. We're going to make it back home safe. But it's only by the goodness of God. It's only by His grace and His mercy. So we have left home. Amen. And not to return. Amen. But God has spared us. Amen. And we are living witness of the goodness of God. Amen. Praise God. We're going to ask you to look on 2 Timothy, the second chapter, and the third verse. If you have it, say amen. Amen. It says, endure hardness as a soldier. A good soldier of Jesus Christ. Amen. Praise God. We have to endure hardness. It didn't say as a soldier. Amen. But it says a good soldier. Amen. There's an adjective describing what type of soldier we have to be. Amen. Endure, praise God, means to suffer. Patience. Amen. Praise God. Sometimes we just don't want. We want everything to come to us, as they say, on a silver platter. It's my way or the highway. My way or no way. But we have to endure hearts. Amen. As a good soldier in Christ Jesus. Now, praise God, Timothy, amen, was being taught and mentored by Paul. And both of them had to have, amen, something in the personality. And Paul was willing to teach Timothy, but Timothy had to endure. And he had to have a spirit of being willing to take teaching. Amen, we don't want to endure because we are not willing to take teaching. But when we endure, praise God, we'll be able to take the good with the bad. Amen. Praise God. Endure as a good soldier.
Yes, Lord.
A good soldier in Jesus Christ. When we endure, praise God, we might get our feet stepped on sometime. We might get our feelings hurt.
Yes, Lord.
And we might be angry. And our mind might wear up. Amen, but we endure, and our friends might get hurt. It's not bad, but we heal them. But it's the way that we handle it. Amen, it's the way, praise God. When we endure, we'll take it. Amen. It will not go down our throat, but we'll take it and go on and learn from it. Amen, but when we are not take teaching, word comes and it steps on our toes, that we are being talked about and preached on, then we get an attitude. But when we do it, praise God, amen, we'll take it that they're doing it for our good.
Yes.
They're trying to help us to, amen, and God.
Amen.
Spiritually.
Amen.
Praise God. Praise God. We don't want to endure the word comes. We want to roll our eyes. Get angry and say, I'm going to throw up my hands and just. But when we endure, praise God, we can go on, praise God, and live from there. And God says it's a good soldier.
Yes, sir.
A good soldier.
Yeah.
Never been in the military, but I've been on the military base when my granddaughter, praise God, was in basic training. Not to be a soldier, you have to go through basic training.
Yeah.
And it might not be as easy as you think it's going to be.
Uh-huh.
You can go through some rigorous training.
Oh.
Amen. God, I remember when I went to pick her up, the horn would blow. And I don't care what they were doing, when that horn blew, they had to stand at attention. So is it within the spiritual walk. When we hear the voice of the Lord, amen, we need to stop and pay attention.
sir.
Not going our own way.
Yes.
But pay attention.
Yes.
What thus saith the Lord. And praise God, because when that horn doing a salute and have attention, they had consequences to pay.
Uh-huh.
Amen. The dream God doing basic training might get all in the face. He might not like the way you look or the way your reactions are. And he can say, give me 50. You got to get down there if you want 50 push-ups to do it. Or you got some consequences to pay. Being a good soldier. Amen. Praise God. It's not going to be a flower bed of ease always.
No.
And you ain't got to realize that the drill sergeant, which is your leaders in Christ, they are telling you something for your good to help you grow in the Lord, to help you, amen, grow spiritually. And it can save your life spiritually and temporally. And a good soldier, praise God, has to be dressed. Amen. If we look at Ephesians 6 chapter and 13th verse, we're going to start at the 13th. We'll take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having all done, to stand, therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the gospel of peace.
Yes, Lord.
Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith you will be able to stand, and shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked, and take the helmet of salvation. The sword of the Spirit,
mm-hmm.
which is the word of God. Amen. When you have, praise God, the whole armor of God, you're going to be able to stand. Amen. You got to take the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Now, you have to have the word of God in you to be able to stand. You have to have the word of God in you to be willing to take teaching. Amen. Praise God. And our teachers come. Amen. To help spiritually.
Yes.
In the Lord.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Praise God. They are human too. Praise God. And sometimes people come from a rough time.
Mm-hmm.
I know this. I know that. But sometimes being human, praise God, things need to be reinforced to us.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes we tend to forget, or we might walk weary. But a soldier, praise God, has to be properly dressed. They have to be properly dressed. And even doing basic training, when you come off the base, you still have to have your uniform on.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. If you get reported, praise God, amen, you have consequences to pay. So we as Christians, let us have on the heart. Let us dress, walk, and love as a good soldier.
Yes, Lord.
Let us do and be as a good soldier in Jesus Christ.
Uh-huh.
We don't have to go out and broadcast it. Said, oh, I'm blessed and I'm highly faithful. I'm fine and feel good. But your life living will speak for you.
Lord,
amen. It will speak for you. Let the world know that you've been born again.
Lord.
Your attitude and your actions will let the world know that you've been born again. When we've been born again, we will love one another.
Yeah.
Amen. When we've been born again, we'll uplift one another and not tear them down. When we love again, praise God, we can see God's face in peace. Amen. Praise God, because we're going to do what thus saith the Lord. When we have the word of God in our heart, and it spreads, praise God. It will show on the outside. There's a song that says, something on the inside. It works on the outside.
Yeah.
Amen. Because it's in the inside. On the inside, it's going to spread.
But
on the inside, it's going to show. Amen. When it's on the inside, you do something about it. Amen. Praise God. If things Amen. Praise God. We'll know, praise God, how to approach people. Amen. Praise God. We don't have to hold up, you know, like those drill sergeants will get in your face and say, soldier, I don't know where you're at. You got to get down there. You got to straighten that. But you got to ask permission to straighten that. Amen. Praise God. So in our spiritual life. To walk in the right way. Yeah. Willing to take teaching. So many are not willing to take teaching. They throw their hands up. Amen. Sometimes we just don't want to go through anything. But look at the afflictions Paul had to go through. Mm-hmm. Amen. He had just thrown his hand on not do it. Mm-hmm. Amen. We have to praise God. When we throw out our hand, we say, Lord, I say to you. I'm leaving it hands. Yeah. I'm leaving it to you, Lord. And you are on me.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. Praise God. And guess what? We got somebody that'll fight our battle.
Yes,
amen. We are in this war, praise God. A spiritual war.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. But let us be a good soldier in Christ Jesus. And let us be able to endure hardship. Let us endure hardship.
Yeah.
Praise God. Don't think everything is going to be easy. Amen. Praise God. Against you when they try to correct you.
Mm-hmm.
But they're amen. They're looking out for your soul.
You.
So let us have courage today to be able to endure hardship.
Yes.
As a good soldier.
Good soldier.
Anybody can be a soldier.
Mm-hmm.
They want to be. But we want to be a soldier in Jesus Christ.
Thank you.